When we started the design process of Amico with Tommy, we needed to figure out what his vision was.
We wanted to create something that personified what Intellivision and our messaging is all about. Something that was exciting and unique and fun.
So we put hundreds of pictures on the wall. We put out lots of words and we talked about the emotional response for what Amico was going to be.
When we were looking at some of the curvatures of the device itself, I gave a lot of reference to, you know, companies like Ferrari, Lamborghini.
We want it to be fun. We want it to be exciting and different.
It's very important to us that it's friendly, that it's approachable, that it's something that you can just pick up, you understand how to use it right off the bat.
During the entire development process, we're continuously asking ourselves, what can we do to make this a better product for the user?
It was also important for us, though, to make something that didn't look aggressive or that wasn't scary piece of technology. You know, we really wanted it to be friendly and to be a part of the living room.
The main reason we designed Amico the way we did in a wedge shape from front to back and top to bottom is, one, it allows people all over the living room to see the lights and participate in the game and really get a feel for what's going on in the environment.
So one of the big things I've been involved with over the last 20 years is my video game concert called Video Games Live. And touring that around the world, you know, I learned a lot of things about how important lighting was to, you know, just the music and the experience, the onstage experience to the audience.
There are 40 independently controlled LEDs on the console base, and then we also have 12 LEDs in each controller for a total of 64. With that many LEDs, the possibilities are endless. You can do everything from having an LED light show to flashing police lights, fireworks show to happy birthday signal. You name it, we can do it.
To make sure the lighting on Amico was a top-notch experience, we went through dozens of design iterations, different materials that diffuse the light. We have a lot of LEDs in the console, and we're dealing with a lot of colors, and it was really important for us to be able to blend these in really interesting ways that correlate to the gameplay or that indicate really interesting things to the user.
We also have interactive lighting in some of the games as well. So, you know, you'll be having to look on the actual base of the machine and dial in different colors on the LEDs in order to get through certain areas or to unlock certain chests or, you know, keys or doorways.
You can also adjust the brightness settings of the LEDs or even turn them off.
It's not only aesthetic, but it really is involved with some of the gameplay and the design in our games. Very unique.
We want Amico to last as long as possible, and a great way to do this is to reduce the amount of moving parts in the system. So we have steady state memory, but we've also gone as far as to design the cooling system in a way that it's totally passive.
We keep Amico cool and at a stable temperature by using passive airflow, so it silently allows the cold air to pass through the system and exit through the back.
We've also designed the console chassis to help facilitate the natural airflow that's already happening.
When designing Amico, it was really important to us to make sure that it would last as long as we possibly could make it last. We want it to last years, maybe even generations. So in an effort to do that, we reduced as many moving parts as we could.
A couple ways that we've worked to achieve this is by selecting engineering grade resins for the plastics, but also designing it in such a way that where it has thick wall thicknesses and structural ribs and a lot of internal components that really increase the strength of the controller and the console alike.
We're happy and proud to announce for the first time that we've actually partnered with Qualcomm and we're using their Snapdragon family of chips. That is the thing that is the heart and soul, the thing that powers Amico.
On the back of the console, you'll find an HDMI out, a power connection, a micro SD card expansion slot for more memory, and a USB-C port for future accessories and expansion.
It's really important for us that people have access to tons of games on their standard system. So with the internal storage on Amico, you can store 40 to 50 games. In addition to the internal storage, we've also added a micro SD expansion so you can store literally hundreds of games on your Amico. Amico has built-in RFID. RFID stands for radio frequency identification. And what that means is you can take an object, tap it on your Amico and have access to new games, new content, and awesome new experiences.
This is going to be used for a number of different things, but mostly with our physical media, which we'll be talking a lot more about at the end of the year. One of the interesting and fun things about the console is the different color combinations.
The way that we have done that is by picking colors that are bright, they're metallic, they have depth.
We use a special process to achieve an amazing finish on the surface of the Amico console.
The standard colors are graphite black and glacier white. We felt it was important to give people color choices as well too, because we really do want this to be the centerpiece in their living room.
We're even obsessed about the textures of all the plastics on Amico. And what we're doing with that is we're selecting a mixture of gloss and matte textures to help highlight curves, highlight surfaces that we want people to see and look at and engage with.
We did some special editions as well, which takes a bigger and different process.
We came up with an advanced manufacturing process for our special editions to ensure that the finishes last for a lifetime.
We're adding metallic vents that actually match the bezel of the special edition to really bring it all together.
We have a galaxy purple, we have the GTO red, and we have the vintage wood grain.
We don't want anyone to find Amico intimidating, and this can be seen in the controller design. We have a lot of similar features to mobile phones.
Color capacitive touchscreen, speaker, microphone, gyroscope and an accelerometer, force feedback, wireless contact charging.
And what that means is playing with an Amico controller is a very simple experience. It's intuitive and it elevates the gameplay experience as well.
These are the kinds of things that we created in order to make very unique and simple game design and gameplay experiences.
Anyone, whether they're a hyper-casual gamer or have never gamed in their life, can pick it up and use it, understand it, and have a ton of fun playing with it.
So of course, my favorite video game machine growing up was the original Intellivision, and I wanted to make sure that we took certain design elements of that, which were very unique.
One unique feature of Amico is that the controllers actually nest inside of the console base. And not only does this harken back to the original Intellivision, but it also gives us a few features that we really think will bring a lot of value to users. A benefit of nesting the controllers in the console is it gives us a place to do wireless contact charging. So all you have to do is drop your controller in and Amico will take care of the rest.
Once you put the controller in the charging base, it takes about 2 hours for a full charge. And with a full charge, you get 4 to 6 hours of gameplay time. Besides the wireless contact charging, you can also charge your Amico controller with a USB-C cable.
The controller can internally sense the orientation you're holding it, similar to your mobile phone, and will adapt the controller to be able to play the game in that way.
At the top of the controller, you'll find the home button. Not only does this allow you to turn the controller on and off, but it also allows you to pause the game, change the orientation of the controller, or get in and out of the game menu.
The contour of the controller was thought out over a year.
Everything from trying 6 to 7 different types of screens to the way the disc is shaped, to the way the shoulder buttons are shaped, or even the overall form factor of the controller and the way the grip is contoured on the back. We really want a controller that fits a wide variety of people. It's designed for kids, elderly, female, males, everyone to be able to pick it up and use it.
We got to a point where everything felt comfortable to everyone, no matter what size or level of gamer you were. And that was very, very important.
All of this provides an easy to use experience that anyone can pick up and enjoy.
We're all about family play, all about multiplayer, couch co-op. Yes, every single game has a single player, but you know, the fun is really to be had when there's more than one person playing.
In the manufacturing world of something so sophisticated as to the Amico controller and console, it's nice to be able to have the other side work with us as a team to be able to circumvent any challenges that may arise.
Arc Electronics, in one form or another, has been around for many years. The factory itself has been operational for close to 30 years. During the last 10 years, we've grown to be one of the very largest manufacturers of high-end electronics. We manufacture millions of controllers and componentry for the prior generation, video game consoles and the future generation.
We can have a success rate of 99.98% of the printed circuit boards coming through as working.
We pride ourselves in the investment in our employees. We care about their health, their family life, their continuing and ongoing education. We're very family-centric, as is Intellivision.
We were so excited with the idea of bringing the family back together, sitting around the couch together.
As the world is changing with respect to environmental responsibility, we have been at the forefront of implementing all the needed changes in our factory process, and we have been awarded multiple certificates for being green and responsible to our environment. One of the things that attracted us to work with Intellivision was the entrepreneurial nature, the passion, the drive that's behind the implementation of the business model.
Immediately, it struck us that this was a passionate, family-oriented, sincere, wonderful group of people. We were absolutely stunned, and we were so much in approval of the concept.
At the end of the day, our goal and mission was to create and design something that no matter what your skill level was, it was easy to pick up and understand.